It looked like somebody was bent over and had their head in the window of the deer blind. It either heard me or smelt me, and he pulled his head out of the tent and stood straight up, and that shocked me. They don't make people that big.
The way it moved, almost as if it was gliding across the beach. I've never seen anything move like that in my life. They were screaming at each other in gibberish. It sounded like a language, and they were chuntering away back and forwards, back and forwards, back and forwards. I know what a bear looks like, and there is no way on this planet that what I saw were bears.
What are you reporting?
Jesus Christ, you better...
Sir?
Yeah.
Hello?
Get somebody out here.
What's going on now, sir?
That son of a bitch is about 6'9", I don't know.
Do you see him now, sir?
Yes, I'm looking right at him. Uh-oh.
My name is Maximus Decimus Meridius, Commander of the Armies of the North, General of the Felix Legions, and you are listening to Sasquatch Chronicles.
Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for being here tonight. Hope you're having a great weekend. We're going to be chatting with Owen tonight. And Owen had an encounter in Ohio, and I kind of did show notes if you guys are following along on the website. And he captured that picture. I posted it on the blog, I think last week. But Owen's going to talk about his encounter tonight and this image he captured. And it's a fascinating account, being that Owen really isn't into Bigfoot. And as you guys listen to it, I know you guys have heard this type of behavior before. Owen just didn't know what was going on. We're also going to be chatting with Jeff. And Jeff comes to us from Maine. And a lot of very strange things were going on the property. But he captured some audio. I played it on Friday night's show. And so we'll be talking about that and then some of the other things that happened on the property. If you've had an encounter and you'd like to be on the show, shoot me an email. My email address is wes@sasquatchchronicles.com. And I have another upcoming show. I'm thinking about posting it tomorrow. But I interviewed Robert Kreider, and it was a very fascinating conversation. And a lot of times when you talk to Bigfoot researchers and you ask them questions, they're great at not really answering your questions. But Robert was very different. He was very cool to talk to. And I even asked him, what is some behavior that you've seen that shocked you? Maybe no one else knows. What's something you've experienced or witnessed that, from these creatures, and you just thought that it was bizarre? And here's his answer. I'll play it for you guys.
First one probably that actually did shock me was the harvesting of blood. So there's a couple different methods, and we've seen it several times. Once was a dog. We slashed its throat, drank all the blood out of it, threw it on the ground in the driveway of the people's place. Another one that is a big impact is when the subject we call George and the subject we call Amos, and we assume George led this whole thing, broke into a family farm, got into their goat enclosure, their chicken enclosure, killed all their goats. There were six or seven. Everyone but one was a clean twist the neck, kill it, puncture the carotid and the femoral artery, and then drain them. And then, but one of them, apparently, this is what, from what we saw, Amos was doing, which is smaller, younger, and less experienced, had a hard time with it, and ended up biting it in the skull and to kill it. And it was a nasty death. That was the only one that was really bad. But yeah, that was the most surprising thing. And what they had done is that after 4 or 5 days of extreme cold weather, below zero temperatures, 35 mile an hour wind, sleet, frozen fog and hail and all kinds of other shit came with that. We had an ice storm, basically. So like a 4 or 5 day ice storm. And then right after that, they did this. And they didn't take a single body with them. And then they returned right back down to the group. And I think that was probably one of the strangest behaviors that was most surprising was the bloodletting. And it's, I mean, there's lots of tribes that do it. It's not something that's undone. So, and that's what I've talked to several doctors about it. And they've actually told me that, well, the freezing cold weather, when you're exposed to it, what you're going to need directly afterwards, the two primary things are iron and salt, period. And they said, so what it sounds like to me is they would just went for a source of known iron and salt. And then only through supposition and how we've seen them act, because they're not that far from habitation, ranches and things, is that they don't mess as a whole. They don't mess with them. The big one don't mess with them. The mama, the other ones, they just don't mess with any of the females, don't go out and do anything. But the young males are cantankerous. So they do. You know, they do. They visit farms. They raid farms. They take animals every once in a while. You know, they cleaned out this guy's birds, all of his birds, which is a bummer, all of his geese and all his stuff. But I know he got to see one of them. I got a feeling it was Amos by the size description. He said it moved like a cat on all fours. When it turned and looked at him, it had a smile that literally looked like it went from ear to ear. And that's a primate fear response, you know. So, but yeah, the younger seem to raid places and the older ones actually don't. So I have a feeling when they did the goats, they didn't take anything back because it's probably a bad idea. I think they're absolutely as wise as us, and knowing that if you did that, you're going to lead trouble home. I doubt they're supposed to do it, you know, because they just don't as a whole.
You know, what's fascinating about what he just said is I kind of think he might be right. I've had a lot of eyewitnesses talk about that, especially on farms and stuff, to where these saints come through and just seem to kill everything just to kill things. And I never really thought about the bloodletting thing. But he has a lot of really cool theories on, there's a lot of things I've never heard before. So I'll be putting that out shortly. I know I asked him about the names, you know, what's the deal with the names? Is that just your way of keeping track of individuals? Is that kind of why you name them?
Yeah, the reason we give them names like that is exactly that. So it's our way of quick reference. And so it's like a number, I guess, in a sense, but they gain kind of a personality after several years of the same subject, you know, observations of their habits and traits and everything. And that's part of it. We call one Jasper, and it's because his foot was so funny shaped when he was small. He kind of grew into it, but he had this huge, long, great toe. And it made his foot look elf-like almost, and he had a pretty narrow heel. And so we called him Jasper, you know. So, it's just a way of internally identifying. It's not so much that, no, we don't know them and know their names, you know what I mean? Yeah.
But that'll be an upcoming show, and I think you guys will actually like it. I learned a lot talking to him. Robert's a pretty fascinating guy. You know, I asked him, where do they go? Why did they build the structures? You know, and he gave a lot of very fascinating theories on why they do what they do and where do they go. So we'll be going into all of that. That'll just be an upcoming show. I hope you guys enjoy it. Let's jump into it tonight. I want to welcome Owen to the show. Owen, thanks for coming on.
Thanks, Wes.
Yeah, Owen, I appreciate you being here. And I know that this happened about 2 weeks ago when you were out hiking. If you would you just kind of start from the very beginning, kind of tell us what you were doing and walk us into what actually happened that day?
Sure. Yeah. So show up there. They have a really large lake. There's probably 3 or 4 people just out on a small kayaks and one medium sized boat just in the lake there. And so walked around the lake for a little bit, just kind of like taking in the view. Walked into the actual forest. There's multiple bike trails and walking trails back there. So I start walking, and you know, somebody started blaring music pretty loud out towards the lake area. So I just wanted to, you know, walk away from that and just, you know, headed into the woods, get some peace and quiet. So I was walking back there. I'd say the whole trail, there are multiple trails. The main one goes around the lake, and it's probably about 7-8 miles long total. So I'm just walking straight back on the trail on my way back there.